Good afternoon and welcome to the show. Here I am again at USA International Speedway in the Dirt Street Stock iRacing Rookie Series. I already had at least one bonehead in practice. Nevertheless, notwithstanding, I'll go out here and do my best and qualify. Track is pretty slick for this series, especially this early. We got a slick track here. You just have to hang on, do the best you can. Car wants to slide around. I think I'm gonna have to use a little bit of brake on entry just to get it to slow down and turn. Give it a shot here. A little bit of brake there, that helps.
One more lap. 28.242.
I don't remember who the bonehead was. A complete idiot in practice. I didn't really get a car number. So we'll just have to watch out for everybody.
There's the flag. It's over.
Didn't do too well in qualifying. There's an eighth position. Not sure where I am as far as iRating goes. Take a look. Looks like I'm number 11, so we must have some pretty good iRating in this rookie race. Or anything about these rookie races, I don't think there are too many rookies running. Not with these kind of iRatings. I've got some static in my audio. I hope you can't hear it. I'm gonna make a slight adjustment. See if I can make that a little better. I don't think it's going out on the microphone. I think it's just coming in my headphones. All right. Let's see where I qualified. I was in eighth. And looks like I'm still in eighth. Now I'm in ninth. As car number 11, I would be satisfied to finish in ninth. But I would like to finish in the top six out of 12 cars would give me a little more of an iRating gain, perhaps. I don't know who we're waiting for. Looks like we got everybody qualified at least one lap. 20 lap race, no cautions. Here we go. Gonna head to the grid here in just a moment. Ashton Lane on the pole in number six. Outside, number one car, highest rated car in the session of Rafael Gaugiuniama. And I'm going to end up back in 11, all the way back to 11th now in car number 11. So I think this is one of those races where I'm going to kind of hang around for the first lap or two, maybe three, and see what happens and see if we have anybody crash out.
On the inside. Pit road is closed.
Or foul up. See how that works out. Maybe make a move a little later. Can't wait too long. It's only 20 laps. So, big track, but still 20 laps is a pretty quick race, even on this big track. Biggest dirt track on the service, 3/4 of a mile, USA International Speedway. Of course, the asphalt version is a high bank track. This is a flat track. I remember when iRacing first created the dirt version of this track in 2017. And the first question that was asked was, why is it flat? iRacing said that the track was just too fast with banking. I don't know about too fast, but probably would have been a problem for a lot of drivers because of the speed. Some drivers would be fine with it, you know, they could handle it, but some, particularly rookie drivers, and it is a rookie track, it's used in the rookie series as evidenced here, this is what I'm running. Oh boy. The quest for 2K continues. I've made it to 1500 even on the iRating. Can I stay at 1500? Can I improve? Will I go down? This race could go either way. I mean, this is not a hard division to race in, really. It's sometimes easy to gain a little iRating in these races. It's also very easy to lose a lot of safety rating in these races. Just gonna try to hang on and not lose too much safety, not to lose. Hopefully gain a little iRating.
About to go green, stay focused.
Already got a blinky in front of me. That's the 10 car, and everybody's checking up. Not sure why.
Post car is off. Green, green, green.
Gonna run in here real hard. The track is slick. Gonna take a kind of a wait and see stance and see how these drivers do. They do seem to have a fairly high strength of field. I'm going to be real patient in this race. At least in the early laps. Use a little bit of brake on entry. We got a couple of cars getting together there already. Picked up a spot out of that. And we're going to have more action as the 7 car overdrives in the turns. He's going crazy. He's out of control. There he goes again, beating and banging on lap 2. Lap 3, actually, but still. Fighting for 10th. Oh, they're going at it now. Gonna try to stay out of that action. Let the 3 car go. Uh-oh.
Car inside.
Had to come to a complete stop there, but I probably didn't really lose any positions. In fact, I probably gained positions up to 10th now. That's unfortunate for all of us. I don't know what happened. I didn't see it until it was too late. I couldn't go anywhere. I locked the brakes down, but that was nothing else I could do about it at that point. And we'll take a look at that after the festivities here are over. Oh, just having fun rolling around. Maybe I can catch this 9 car. 9 started way in the back and really didn't come on strong, and he may be maybe a little newer to the dirt street stock or something along those lines. Doesn't seem to be pushing very hard. Running the outside, and I'm going to try to get under him. I think he's just going to let me go. I'm not going to push it too hard. I just want to get that spot back if I can. Gonna try to roll around the bottom here. I could do a lot of steering back there, probably too much, and probably one of the things that slows me down. Up to 9th now, that's good. It's 2 positions above my rating. Hopefully it'll be good enough to at least break even on the iRating. I got a feeling I'm going to lose a little safety. Don't know yet. I'm going to try running. I don't know if the high line ever comes in here.
Great job. 10 to go.
I doubt if this high line's going to work at all. No. Better off down low. See if I can catch this 4 car up here. That's Hudson in the 6th position. I don't think he's in 6th anymore. 3 cars stopped up high. Really tough. The track is quite slick. The 9 car is coming on, and he got me. That was my fault, really. I got 2 sideways there.
Inside. Clear inside.
Made it up to 8th, and now I'm back to 10th. And probably going to lose safety rating and probably I rating also. As the quest for 2K continues. Quite honestly, not a big deal to me. Just having fun. If I get the 2K, that's good. Eventually, if I keep trying, I'll get there. This track is slow. This is a slow track. You really got to get slow down in the corners because there's really no outside. You gotta run the inside, and the inside is pretty well slicked off.
27.757.
Jeez. Fighting the wheel there, about to get lapped. Actually, they're a little ways back. I got the 5 car coming up on me. That's for position. But I think he's gonna run out of laps unless I mess up again. Trying to stay off of that grass. I don't mind clipping a little, but getting way up on it's just gonna slow me down. Really not good racing conditions. It's okay. I mean, it's an okay track. It's just this car not well suited for these conditions. I'm not sure why the car wants to go so low on exit over there. Coming to the white flag finally. And go out and see what kind of disaster this race turned out to be. Like I said, it's not a big deal. Still had fun driving around, getting wrecked, stepping on my own, you know what. Finished in 10th.
There's the flag. It's over. Nice run. Solid work.
Why you stop in the middle of the track? Why do you do that? I guess you like losing safety rating. I don't particularly like it. All it takes is a quick look in the rear view if you got one on. You may not have one on. And all it takes is a little common sense not to stop in the middle of the track immediately after the race is over. It's that simple. All right. Gonna take a look at the results. Read them and weep. Actually, before we look at the results, let's take a look at these wrecks. There's the one in which I was involved. Here I go down the back stretch into the turn, and no, that's not it. Oh, yes, it is. 7 went around. If we could see exactly how that shook out. A little far chase. Up here to the 7 car. What happened to the 7 car? He got nailed by the 5 car. 3 car tries and successfully avoids it. Somehow I'm on the wrong car. Should be looking at Alexander Pig here. The 7 car. 7 gets nailed and the 5. 3 nails the 5 and takes him on around, and I come in and 5 just sits there. Like a bump on a log. Okay, moving along. The 1 and the 4. They get together a little bit. Looks like this is for second position. And the 1 just beats on the 4. And uses him up a little bit in that turn. Here comes the 2. To take advantage of that situation. More of the same. The 4, oh, bad luck for the 4. He nailed that wall. He clipped that wall on the inside. The 1 car out in the lead. A Barbie car. I don't know. I don't know what kind of man would drive a Barbie car. I'm sorry, but it's... There's the 4 and the 8 crashing. The 3's involved. The 3 had some terrible luck. I saw him go in the pits at one point. 3 comes into that one. This is going to be the end of the race where the guy slams on the brakes right in front of me. The 7 car. Not too bright. Okay. Now we can go back and take a look at the results. Here we are with the results. Minus 0.54 safety rating. That is a big loss. Jumped over the 4 hole numbers, so it added a lot in there because of that jump. Minus 35 iRating, so it went from 1,500 to a 1,465. Yes, big loser on that one. But anyway, had fun anyway. Thank you for watching. I appreciate it, and I'll have more later.